I never pick up money ever. Ah, ever.
Hi guys, welcome back to our headquarters. Make sure that you subscribe in order to be part of the revolution gang. Turn on your post notifications so that you can get notificated when every time when Benita drops a new video. And then I suggest you check out my personal favorite, it's titled Are You Smarter Than a Fifth Grader? Thank you.
So in today's video, we are doing a faith-based video, baby!
Hallelujah, I feel him down in my spirit.
So for those of you who do not know, I am a Christian, and let me start off by confessing that I believe in my heart, as I confess with my tongue, that Jesus Christ is Lord. And I believe that he died on the cross for me, for the remission of all sin, that I may be forgiven and united with my Father God in heaven.
My soul cries out hallelujah, thank God for saving me.
I'm going to be talking about five things that you should be praying for that you might forget to pray for, might not think to pray for, or you might think are too small to pray for. So the first thing that I pray for, and I think everybody should pray for, is your money. I believe that everyone should pray for their money when you receive it, when you get paid, when you receive money. Pray over the money and pray that the money will be fruitful or multiply, that wherever you send out the money, it will work for your good, it will work for your growth, for your development. Praying that your money will not disappear, that you will not work like an elephant, eat like an ant, that you won't be in a situation where you earn enough but somehow you just don't ever have enough to cover your living expenses. And this does not apply if you are living above your means. Get your budget together. Another thing is, of course, if you are a Christian, then you should be tithing. It's a personal decision, but it's in the Bible. But anyway, and if you are tithing, you know, of course, praying over your tithe, praying that God receives it, that he does as he promised he would do for those who do give their tithe. But yeah, definitely, guys, you should always be praying for your money as you receive it. Another thing is, well, this is not really something I pray for, but I never pick up money ever. Because I just feel like it's, I feel like it's what's the Christian equivalent of bad luck? I don't know, because you know Christians don't work on luck, but it's, I just don't think it's good. I don't think it brings good things to your life. I feel like if money is meant to come to me, and I always pray to God that money will find me, money will follow me. And when money does find me or follow me, I'm not going to be picking it up from the ground like I'm some kind of, you know, beggar or something. And I'm not going to gain financially by someone else's loss because they lost their money, it fell. And also, if you are spiritual, then I also believe that if you pick up money from the ground, like, you don't know what, some people might have dropped it, other people may have planted it, you don't know what they spoke over that money, what they said over it, for those who pick it up. So I don't pick up money, but if you pick up money, then pray for it, you know, pray for that money that you're picking up, and pray it doesn't curse your life. This is something that I do, especially as someone who uses like some kind of public transport. I always pray over every car that I enter. When I touch the handle, I just say blood of Jesus Christ. And when I enter the car, I'll either just say blood of Jesus or I'll just say a mini prayer. But just praying for every car that I enter, that no weapon formed against me shall prosper. If this person was thinking of kidnapping me, they must forget it now in Jesus' name.
You are a liar.
I seriously pray for every single car that I enter. And I don't just pray for cars of people I don't know. I also pray when I enter my car or when I enter the car of people I do know. But just praying that God basically be with us as we drive, get us home, get us to our destination and home in peace, you know. Because one thing we as people take for granted is the fact that leaving your house and coming back is the biggest miracle ever, guys. I'm telling you, car accidents are so common, man. But yeah, no, praying for every car. And I also pray for the roads that I drive on. Before I leave my house or as I'm in the car, I pray that every road I drive on will be safe for me, will not harm me, I will not be in an accident. I pray that God's angels go before me. I pray for my going out and my coming in. So just basically travel mercies every single day. The next thing is praying for every single house that you enter, especially when you are entering houses for the first time or you're not too sure about the people, whether it's a meeting or friends, or even if you do know them, but always praying for every house that I enter. I do this because you never know what spirits are hanging around people's houses. Hey, even if they're Christians, you never know what's going on in their homes, in their lives. Being Christian doesn't mean like your life is absolute perfection. You know, there are some Christians who are battling some serious demons and stuff. So I always pray for every house I enter. And I read a verse before that said that every house you enter, call peace upon that house, something along those lines. But I just pray that every house I enter, no spirit will attach to me, no spirit will follow me. I'm not going to leave my house with the Holy Spirit and come out with some familiar or unfamiliar spirits. But praying for every house that I enter. And also, you never know what people's intentions are, again, especially with people that you don't know so well. You know, some people do rituals where they put stuff by their gates, and it's like as soon as you cross the gates, something must happen to you, a cloud will follow you, or you know what I mean. And I know this probably, if you're not spiritually inclined, if you don't believe in spiritual warfare, if you don't believe in demons and stuff like that, then this whole video for you is just a whole lot of baloney and superstition. But for those of you who do believe, pray for every single house that you enter. And also remember to pray for your house. You know, there are people who do crazy magic charm and witchcraft who try to put things when they might be your guests, right? And they come to your house, when they enter, they make sure they sprinkle something by your gate, or you know what I mean. But so not just praying for houses you enter, but also remembering to pray for your household. The next prayer is to pray for protection regarding every single person you come across. Again, you never know who people are, you never know what people are into. A prayer I always make is, Lord, protect me, anyone who I come in contact with, if they're evil, if they're demonic, if they want to, you know, freaking initiate me into a cult or like whatever weird stuff. I always pray to say, Lord, protect me. Every hand I shake, I will not receive anything. I will not, you know what I mean? So I just pray that every encounter I have will not be spiritually malicious for me. And if people are spiritually malicious, that no weapon formed against me shall prosper, that I will not connect to any of their, you know, evil spirits or demonic spirits and stuff. So I pray for every single person I come in contact with. I also pray for favor when I'm going into meetings, new spaces and stuff, and just say that, Lord, when they see me, they must favor me. When they feel my presence, see my face, they must favor me. They must feel happy, they must feel at peace, they must feel, you know what I mean? And this actually goes to my last point, where again, pray when you enter meetings, boardrooms and stuff like that, but also pray for anywhere where they are calling your name. So I pray against anywhere they are calling my name negatively, where they're calling my name in front of evil altars and shrines, calling my name for evil, for witchcraft. I pray against that, and I say, God, anywhere they call my name, Holy Spirit, arrive in my place, you know, show up. When they call me, you must show up, you know. So praying against where they call my name for evil, but also pray against anywhere my name is being said, it must be said for good, in meetings, in boardrooms, in classrooms, in private discussions, anywhere my name pops up, it must be for good, in Jesus' name. People must not find themselves, you know, hating me for no reason and stuff like that. And again, this is a spiritual thing, and let me make this clear, this is by no means saying that everyone is going to like you and you're going to be the favorite person of everyone in the whole wide world. By the way, this is a prayer for favor, and God will give you favor where favor is required, you know what I mean? But yeah, this is not to say everybody's gonna be your friend, please. please, that's not what I'm saying at all. But yeah, so just praying that where they call your name, it must be for good. When they're evaluating your business, your proposal, your speech, your this, your that, it must be for good. I make that prayer. And again, also praying that any room I enter must favor me, especially for work, business opportunities and stuff like that, you know. And I pray that when I enter, my presence must be felt, and not just my presence because I'm so cool, but the God, you know, be my presence. You know, I always say, God, when I enter, Lord, be my presence. Anyway, guys, so this was a pretty short video. I didn't want to make it too long. Those are some of the things that I pray for that, you know, I know some people forget to pray for, don't know what to pray for. And even, it's not even about other people. It's just for me, small prayers that I always try to make every day for protection and for favor. And, you know, for God to take absolute and 100% control. God is in charge. And that's it for today, guys. I hope you liked this video. Don't forget to comment, like, share, and subscribe. And I will be back with more videos. Any videos that you guys want me to make, comment down below, and I'll try and make it happen for you. Peace and love, guys.